Well, if you look here at the riverfront in Hudson, you can see it looks like they've made some pretty good waterfront developments. But take a look over here, just a few hundred feet away. You've got empty warehouses, empty land.
And that is where this all happened, just outside a Rite Aid store, if that helps viewers get an idea of exactly where on that piece of street it is.
We get to speak with you today, Reed, because you are a graduate of RPI, just the third from that school, I believe, to make it into space.
Now, another murder suspect, Salomon Najera Hernandez, gave a similar statement to police. He said, quote, "I went upstairs and saw the second victim all beat up and lying face down on the floor."
The 145 cannons being ordered are not being made for the United States. These cannons are being made for India. But there's only one organization making it more difficult to run his business. The New York State Liquor Authority.
Talk that up because...
All right, you heard the breaking news live here on Time Warner Cable News. Syracuse Police Chief Frank Fowler announcing an arrest in today's frightening double shooting on West Onondaga Street.
Back to you, Jeff.
All right, good information. Brad, we can't let you go without taking a bite of that apple. Come on, the big crunch. Got to hear it.
Let's check it out.
In the quiet hills of Schoharie County.
I love this country. Pan around and take a look at this.
Lives the happiest 90-year-old widower you may ever meet.
I feed my birds here every single morning.
Up here, Joseph Salomon is just known as Uncle Joe.
I'm 90, and I went horseback riding twice last summer.
But living on fixed income in a near 200-year-old back road farmhouse has challenges.
Well, here.
Like this.
The sink is off. The sink is on.
You've likely figured it out by now. The sink quit working.
Hey, the sink is off?
Joe's well pump broke during last week's blizzard.
What else can I tell you? That's God's honest truth.
So down the hill in Middleburg, in a village hall only 47 years older than Joe.
One of Uncle Joe's friends called me.
The mayor, Matt Avitable, heard about it.
One of the things that popped in my head was a GoFundMe page.
Avitable launched it on Sunday. By Monday at noon.
We're at $925. 14 people have donated.
The cost to fix Joe's well pump is about $1,600. Avitable, who also runs the local Mountain Eagle newspaper, hopes his readers will help reach the goal by Tuesday.
People here are giving. They think with their heart.
I'm stunned. I mean, honest to God, I'm overwhelmed. I can't believe this.
On Tuesday, Joe's well pump will be repaired. And when the snow melts, he wants to have every donor over for a barbecue.
Why not? You know, treat people good to treat you good. You know, that's the name of the game.
The game that keeps Joe happy. In Middleburg, Jeff Reddick, Spectrum News.
Good evening to you, Kate. Police transported her 2.5 hours from Rensselaer County to here in Clinton County. But Joyce Mitchell's court date barely lasted 2.5 minutes.
Silent going in.
Joyce, why did you do it?
And silent coming out. Joyce Mitchell went before the judge again on Monday, but this time in jail fatigues and shackles.
Bail has been set at $100,000 cash, $200,000 bond.
The 51-year-old stands accused of providing tools to Clinton Correctional inmates Richard Matt and David Sweat, a move contributing to the convicted killer's escape. Monday's appearance was merely procedural for Mitchell, changing attorneys due to a conflict of interest before waiving the hearing altogether. She will appear next in Clinton County Court.
This obviously has become a national, media high-profile case.
Outside, Clinton County DA Andrew Wiley did not rule out more arrests aside from Mitchell for the escape. He also alluded to what may have been Joyce Mitchell's sinister plan for her husband with the two escapees.
An agreement between Joyce Mitchell and both Matt and Sweat as to whether they were going to harm Lyle Mitchell. I'm not going to comment on that.
These guys are supposedly still around, so it's very nerve-wracking.
The search rolled on into its 10th day Monday, but kids did go back to school for the first time since last Wednesday, with no outdoor activities and under the watchful eye of sheriffs and troopers.
It is scary because you can't have your kids outside playing. That's a sad thing when you think about it.
No new updates from state police Monday, no inmates found, and no indication when or if the search will end.
Tuesday is set to be the 11th day of searching here, Kate. Now more than 800 searchers are canvassing about 1,000 acres of woods so far, with much more to go. David Kay sleeps in this burgundy recliner now.
It's tough being by yourself at night, it really is.
This is the folder, very large.
Michelle Kay spends days and nights at the dining room table.
This particular tab is all of David's medical, and it's a lot, all medical.
It is a new life for the Kays at their Euclid Avenue home in Troy, much of it spent apart.
It was just paperwork after paperwork coming into the house.
Here in the chair, how long has it been? Ever since I got home from Albany Med, from April up, probably up until now.
It wasn't always this way for the Kays. In fact, up until about 13 months ago, life was pretty normal for Michelle and David. But one day, in March 2015, on about this stretch of the Northway, all of that changed.
It wasn't snowing, wasn't raining, it was clear.
Michelle and David had pulled over on the Northway shoulder to check a problem with their car.
It was the front bumper it had dropped down.
David quickly fixed it.
Got back in the car, buckled our seatbelts, and we were smashed into.
Rear-ended, driver's side. Their trunk and back seat were shoved into the cockpit. David was cut from the car and rushed to Albany Medical Center. He nearly died.
The first week, he doesn't really remember.
I wouldn't remember one thing about the first week. I couldn't even get up in my bed to look in the mirror to see how I looked.
Broken ribs, broken vertebrae, internal injuries, and bleeding. David Kay was alive, but forever changed. And then came word about the other driver.
He was not in control of his car. He almost killed us.
Violation of section 120.03.
Larry Lindstedt, then 23 years old, was driving his stepfather's vehicle without a license that day. He would later tell a judge he was on the prescription sedative Xanax and had also been smoking marijuana.
We start by apologizing to the victims here and the victim's family.
This past week, a year after the crash, Lindstedt was sentenced to 1 to 3 years in prison. Lethargic and sleepy, his stepfather told us Larry had been wide awake the entire night before. It was the first time that David and Michelle ever saw the young man who tore their life apart.
And when I heard those handcuffs click on, that was kind of like very symbolic. That meant there was a closure. But there's still a lot of unresolved issues for me, because a lot of decisions I would have liked to make in my life have been taken away from me.
David Kay was forced to retire from his state job. That early exit meant his pension was slashed. Now Dave is on disability and angry.
When my friends say, oh, you're retired now, Dave. You must be having a lot of fun now. You got all the time in the world. What do you do with that time?
A marriage of 31 years became strained.
I come home and he's in a bad mood, or he doesn't know, and he's bored, or he's upset, or depressed, and trying to figure out what to do with his life now. And his life is my life. It's what do we do? Two?
Just two. Two would be fine.
With all that is now behind them, and all that is still ahead, only one thing is truly clear for the Kays. Drugged driving tears lives apart.
Just because they put all these ads about drunk driving and all that doesn't make it any less or any more, any worse or any better. You know, it's all bad.
You don't do it. You don't do it. You don't take somebody else's drugs. You don't drive. There's a reason why there are labels put on medicine bottles when you get them from the pharmacy. Just for this reason.
Jeff Reddick, Time Warner Cable News.